Ladies and gentlemen, this is Wally Butterworth. Perhaps some of you have heard my radio broadcasts of Voices That Live, which feature the recordings of the world's great singers of the past. When Caruso was asked what should be done with the master record of the Vecchia Cimarra, he laughed and said with a sly wink, "I think we'd better break him up. I don't want to spoil the bass business." And that is why this record has been lost from the RCA Victor record vaults for 33 years. My two-year search for the famous coat song led up many a blind alley to disappointment, through England, Canada, and the entire United States, with final success coming in California. There, his intimate friend, Dr. Mario Marafiotti, had preserved the priceless copy Caruso gave to him. And so we are able to offer it to the world. I am proud to introduce on this record the celebrated singer who shared honors across the footlights with Caruso for many years, Madame Frances Alda. It was she who sang with him that eventful night which preceded the making of this record. Madame Alda.
Of course, I am simply delighted to tell the story which brought about the making of this fantastic record by the immortal Caruso. We, Caruso, Scotti, Segorola, and myself, went to Philadelphia to sing a performance of La Bohème. In those days, you know, the Metropolitan Opera Company went in a special train every Tuesday to Philadelphia, which we all looked forward to with great delight and glee, because going over, we laughed, joked, and had a great deal of fun. During this particular performance of La Bohème, we played a lot of jokes on one another. When, lo and behold, all of a sudden, during the last act, where, as you know, Mimi the soprano lies dying on the bed, Rodolfo the tenor, broken-hearted, sitting by her side, Colleen, just about to sing his famous coat song, turned to us and said, in a very husky whisper, "I've lost my voice. I can't sing." "Non fa niente," replied Caruso. "You just stand still and move your lips, and I'll sing it for you." And sing it he did, marvelously, with his back turned to the audience. I felt like sitting up in my bed and joining in the applause, which Segorola quite seriously was acknowledging with deep, profound bows, the audience not realizing that it was Caruso who had sung. When the final curtain fell, we all begged him to make a record of it. And so here it is, the greatest tenor of them all, singing the bass aria from Puccini's La Bohème.
Yeah.